गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ ज्योमेट्री एंड मेंसुरेशन। दैट्स अवर प्रैक्टिस सेशन नंबर 10। दीज सेशंस आर वेरी हेल्पफुल फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर गोइंग फॉर एसएससी प्री एंड मेंस एग्जामिनेशन। यू मे कनेक्ट मी ऑन माई फेसबुक एट द रेट दिनेश मिगलानी। माई व्हाट्सअप नंबर 09215514435 फॉर एनी क्वारी और एनी एडवाइस और सजेशन। यू मे सेंड ईमेल एट माई ईमेल आईडी legalbuddy@gmail.com। My YouTube channel @DineshMiglani, you may subscribe that, as well as you may recommend this channel to your students, classmates, friends who are going for SSC, government jobs, CAT, management entrance examinations. Let us start with the first question of this session. It is given that the length of each edge of a regular tetrahedron is 10. We have to find the total surface area, right? Before starting this, first of all, there is a need to understand what is tetrahedron. Tetrahedron is sort of a prism whose all edges are in the shape of an equilateral triangle. All surfaces are in the shape of equilateral triangle, right? Now I have to find the total surface area. I know that now we have four equilateral triangles. Area of one equilateral triangle is root 3 by 4 a square. So just multiply it by 4, right? So here I can say that formula we use for finding the total surface area of a tetrahedron, right? Now here a is given as 12. So my answer is 144 root 3. That becomes my answer. Fourth is my answer. I hope the idea is clear. Means if you have to find the total surface area of a tetrahedron, it means your formula should be root 3 a square, because tetrahedron includes the four equilateral triangles. For finding the total surface area, it should be root 3 a square. Let us have the next question. A parallel pipe whose sides are in the ratio of 2:4:8 have the same volume as that of a cube. Find the ratio of their surface area. Right. Now what I can say here, that let us say the sides are 2x, 4x and 8x. Or I may say sides are 2, 4 and 8. It's a better choice. Take it as 2, 4 and 8. Right. It has same volume as that of a cube. Just take the volume. Volume is 64. Let us say side of the cube is a. The volume is a cube. Here I can say side of the cube is said to be 4, right? Now we have to find the ratio of their surface areas. First I take surface area of a parallel pipe, that is twice of LB 8 plus BH plus HL, right, is to 6 a square. Now I can say 40 plus 16, 56 into 2 is to 96, right? Now we have to solve it to 48. Now 8 will go on 6, 8 will go on 7. So I can say ratio is 7:6, right? So here I can say 4th is my answer. Because what he has given in the question, he has given that the sides of a parallel pipe, earlier I also told you, parallel pipe is same as to a cuboid, right? We have taken that 2, 4 and 8. Now with that we can compare the volume with a cube, we can find the side of the cube, then we can solve it, right? Here answer is said to be 4:7:6. Let us have the next question here. The radius of two circles are 5 and 12. The area of a third circle is equal to sum of the area of the two circles. We have to find the radius of third circle, right? Now what I can say? Let us say area of these two circles, that is pi r square plus pi r square. So let us say pi 25 plus 144, right? This is equal to third circle radius. Area cancel out, r is equal to 13. So we can say radius of third circle is equal to 13 centimeter. First becomes my answer. Next question is, sphere and a hemisphere have the same volume. What is the ratio of their curved surface area? Sphere and hemisphere, right? So let us say 4/3 pi r1 cube, that's a sphere, and hemisphere 2/3 pi r2 cube, right? It is given that they have the same volumes. So what I can say, pi is cancelled out, 3 is cancelled out. Here I can say r1 cube by r2 cube is said to be 2/4, we may say 1/2, right? We have to find the ratio of their curved surface area. We know that curved surface area is for a sphere, it should be 4 pi r square. So I may say 4 pi r1 square. It should be 2 pi r2 square, right? Pi is cancelled out, so you may say 2r1 square is to r2 square, right? So what I need my, because I have to find the ratio here, what I need, that I need simply the ratio of R1 square is to R2 square, because I need that value, right? Now what I can say is that we have to just try to replace it. What I can say here, I can say that R1 set to be is equal to R cube R2 by 2, right? And because that power will go there, that is 3, and I just take the cube root, so that should R2, it should be 2 raised to power 1 by 3. That I can say, right? Now I can replace that value here. That would be R2 square would be cancelled out. I get it as 2 divided by 2 raised to power 1 by 3 is to 1, right? Now I have to answer my question. I may say that may come on the upside, so it should be 2 raised to power 2 by 3 is to 1. 2 raised to power 2 by 3 is to 1. Here I can say second becomes my answer. Right, now questions are very simple. Whatever is given to us, we have to simply compare that, and finally I can say answer is said to be second one. Let us have the next question. If the slant height of a right pyramid with square base is 4 and total slant surface area of a pyramid is 12, then the ratio of the total slant surface and area of the base. Okay, now what the problem here is, slant height of a right pyramid with square base. So what is given to us, if we just look at the figure, that figure is to state it to us. Let us say it's a pyramid, right? Slant height is given, but this length is given to us as a 4, right? Then total surface area of a pyramid is 12 square unit. Now I have to find the total surface area. How to find the total surface area? That is said to be pi. You may say that is said to be, if you have to take the total surface area, the formula for total surface area is area of the square a square plus perimeter of the base into slant height divided by 2. That was the formula, right? Now I know that this is a square plus perimeter of the base, we know that is 4a by 2. Slant height is given to us 4, this is equal to 12, right? From where I can find the value of a, so that will go on 2. So I may say 8a, so it would be taken as a square plus 8a, and that would say minus 12 equal to 0. So, right, so what I can say is that would be taken as now a square plus 8a minus 12 is equal to 0, right? Because the total slant surface area is given as 12 square units, that I can say. So what I have to find out? I have to find the ratio of the area of the base to that, right? If I have to find the area of the base to that, so what is expected from me? I have to find the a square simply. I have to take that, right? So what I have to do, just take it again. Total surface area 12, this is equal to area of the base a square plus. And the curved surface area is perimeter of the base by 2 into slant height. So that is said to be 2 will go on 2. It is 8a. Here I can say a square plus 8a minus 12 equal to 0, right? Now, what I have to find that, I need here value of a. Once you have the a, then you can answer it. But here problem is with a given equation, we cannot find out a, right? If that is 12, then we can say. But here if I just try to find out, what I can say, so for a, problem here is, there is some, seems to be mistake. Let us have the look again. Slant height is given to us, right? Perimeter of the slant height of a right square base is 4 meters. Slant height is 4, that is given to us. So our formula is area of the base. I hope there may be some problem, because his total slant area, total slant, it should be total surface area. But he is mentioning you the slant. So there may be a chance that he is not taking the area of the base here. He is just taking that. There may be a possibility, because otherwise our answer is not going to match. Here I can see if I take that to be a will 2. Here I can say 12 by 8. If I take that way, right? Here it would be 12 by 8. You may say 12 by 8. I may say that is 4 3 by 2. In that case, it should be 3 by 2. I have to find the area of the base is to total slant surface area, that is 12 is to area of the base is 9 by 4, right? If I take that 3, 3, 3, 4, I am getting 16 ratio 3. My answer is first one, right? So here, one point we can say that when we say total slant surface, right? Slant surface ke andar, we are nowhere supposed to include the area of the base. We are primarily concerned with total slant surface, means that is simply taken as the lateral surface area, right? On that basis, our answer would be that one. Let us have the next question. Each edge of the regular tetrahedron is 3, we have to find the volume, right? The formula for finding the volume of a regular tetrahedron is a cube upon 6 root 2. क्या फॉर्मूला है? a cube upon 6 root 2, if a is the side, my answer is 27 by 6 root 2, 3239, right? So here I can say 9 by 2 root 2, right? For better simplification, just multiply by root 2, divide by root 2, you may say 9 root 2 by 4, okay? So what I can say here, that I may say that the volume of the regular tetrahedron is said to be 9 root 2 by 4 cubic centimeter. First is my answer, right? So what we have done, just pay attention again. Side is given, now that's a very important formula, because that formula is generally not given in the books. So what you can say, a cube by 6 root 2, that becomes my answer, okay? Let us have the next question here. Just try to understand it. There is a pyramid on a base which is regular hexagon of side 2, 2a, right? If each slant edge of that pyramid is of 5a by 2, volume of this pyramid, right? Now, we have to find the volume of the pyramid. So what I can say, just have attention here. The base is regular hexagon. It is somewhere in that base. And side is given as 2a, right? Somewhere it is at the top. So what I can say, I may say that if I just try to understand the basic concept here. It is given in that way, right? It's a pyramid sort of. If I look at this figure, so that figure is somewhere said to be a pyramid, right? Now problem here is, what is given to us? Each of slant edge of pyramid is 5a by 2, right? Means the slant height is given to us. Sorry, slant edge is given, that is 5a by 2. That edge is given as 5a by 2, right? And this is given as 2a, okay? We have to find the volume of the pyramid. Now we know that the volume of the pyramid can only be found when, because area, volume of the pyramid is 1 by 3 into area of the base into height, right? Area of the base can be found easily because it's a hexagonal shape. We need the height. So what I can say, that is 2a, right? That is 5a by 2. I have to find that height. Applying Pythagoras, I can say height is equal to 5a by 2 square, 25a square by 4. Minus, right, 4a square, that you can say. So that would be 16a square, so we may say 9a square by 4, you may say 3 by 2a. So height is said to be 3 by 2a. Now try to answer it. So volume is 1 by 3 into area of the base, hexagon 6 into root 3 by 4 into side square, that is 4a square, into height 3 by 2a. Right, now just try to solve. We may say that 2, 3, 6, that is cancelled out, 4 is cancelled out. Here it is 3 root 3 a cube, that becomes my answer. Here I can say third one is my answer. Now in this question, what is expected from you? It is expected that you have to find the height of the pyramid. Okay, and how height can be found? Because slant edge is given to us and we know that base, that is 2a, that is height. Apply Pythagoras, with that you can find the height. Once you have the height, you know that pyramid is said to be 1 by 3 into area of the base into height. My answer is said to be third one. Let us have the next question here. Just try to understand the question. The base of a right prism is an equilateral triangle of area 173 centimeter square and volume of the prism is 10380 cubic centimeter, area of the lateral surface area of the prism, right? Now what I can say that the formula for volume of the prism is area of the base into height, right? And formula of the lateral surface area is perimeter of the base into height, right? Now what I need in both cases, first of all I need height, because area of the base is given to us 173 into height and this is equal to 10380, that is given to us, right? Now from here I can find h. 10380 by 173, just solve it. You may say h is said to be 60. Height you have, one thing you have. Now we need the side. So how to take side, because it is given that root 3 would be taken as 1.732. So we know that area is under 3 by 4 a square equal to 173, right? Now that would be divided by 100. Here I can say side is 20, right? I have to find the lateral surface area, perimeter of the base into height. Now perimeter of the base is said to be 60 and height is 60. 60 into 60, 3600. So here I can say माई लेटरल सर्फेस एरिया इज सेट टू बी 3600, थर्ड बिकम्स माई आंसर, राइट? आई होप द आइडिया इज क्लियर. वट आई कैन सी हियर दैट आंसर इज सेट टू बी थर्ड वन, 3600 स्क्वायर सेंटीमीटर. लेट अस हैव द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. थ्री स्फेरिकल बॉल 1, 2 and 3 सेंटीमीटर रेडियस आर मेल्टेड टू कन्वर्ट इन टू ए सिंगल स्फेरिकल बॉल. इन द प्रोसेस लॉस ऑफ मटेरियल इज 25%. वट इज द रेडियस ऑफ द न्यू बॉल, राइट? वट वी नीड, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी टेक द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द न्यू बॉल. जस्ट एड ऑल दम, पाई दैट इज 4/3 पाई आर क्यूब. लेट अस से आर क्यूब एड इट, 1 + 8 + 27. तो आई में से 36 × 4/3 पाई, बट लॉस इज 25%, इट मीन्स वट इज लेफ्ट 75%. नाउ दिस इज इक्वल टू 4/3 पाई आर क्यूब. That's my question. I have to find the value of R. What I can say, this is cancelled out. Okay. Now, just solve it. 25, 3, 25, 4. 4 will go on 9. Here I can say R cube is equal to 27 or R is equal to 3. Third is my answer. The radius of the new ball is said to be third, 3 centimeter. That becomes my answer. Right? A very simple question. Because here 25% of the matter have been lost. It means I have to take it as 75/100. And then I have to compare with the volume of the sphere. Just look at the figure, find the volume, right? A very simple thing, take the volume of cylinder, cone and sphere. The radius of the sphere is 3.5, height 6, and here the radius is 3.5 and total height would be, this is 6, 3.5, 9.5 and height is said to be 6, right? Just add them and answer it, your answer will be there. Just look at the next question. If the weight of a cubic meter of a metal is 480, the weight of a cubic meter, it means I can say one cubic meter in weight terms, that is said to be 480 kg. It is melted and cast into a square rod whose length is 4 meter, right? If I talk about a square rod, so that would be somewhere in the form of a cuboid, right? If I say side is A, so I can say volume is said to be 4A square. Because A into 4, that is the length, right? Now it is given that a solid cube is taken out from one end of the rod. Now it is converted into a square rod whose length is 4 centimeter, right? That is, I may say that is said to be 4A square equal to 1. 4A square equal to 1, so I can find A here. So A would be taken as 1/2, right? Now the question here is, one solid cube is taken out of it. So I can say that the edge of the cube is 1/2, the volume is 1/8, so I have to find its weight. So what I can say, if one cube is equal to 480, then 1/8 is equal to 60. Here my answer is said to be fourth one, 60 kg becomes my answer. Very interesting question. What we have done here, just pay attention. We can say that one cubic meter is equal to 480 kg. Now, the next point that is given to us, that it is melted and cast into a square rod whose length is 4 meter. So I may say 4a square equal to 1, a equal to 1/2, that is given to us. Now a cube have to be taken. Cube means edge of the cube is 1/2, volume is 1/8. Now I can say 1 cubic meter is 480, so 1/8 is said to be 60, fourth becomes my answer. Let us take the next question. Sector of a circle of radius 12 subtends an angle of 120 at the center. I am just explaining it, otherwise there is no need to make the figure. 120 degree, this is 12 and 12, right? The sector is folded in such a way that both terminals, the radius are joined. Find the volume of the cone, right? I know that when we join them, then slant height would be 12. Length of the arc, that would be 2 pi r theta by 360. Becomes equal to perimeter of the base of the cone, right? Cancel out 3, 4. Here I can say R is equal to 4, right? But I can say the radius is 4 and here the slant height is equal to 12, right? So from that, first of all, what is required from us? First of all, we have to find the H, right? First we find the H and then we can find the volume, right? That is 12. I may say that L is 12, then 2 pi r, right? 120 is given by 360 equal to that circumference 2 pi r. 2 pi is cancelled out. 123, 3 will go on 4. R is 4, and then it can be solved. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन हेयर इज हाइट ऑफ ए कोन इज 30 सेंटीमीटर. ए स्मॉल कोन इज कट ऑफ एट द टॉप बाय ए प्लेन पैरेलल टू द बेस. इफ इट्स वॉल्यूम बी 1/27 ऑफ द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द गिवन कोन एट व्हाट हाइट अबव द बेस सेक्शन हैज बीन मेड. राइट, इट इज गिवन इन सच ए वे, इट इज गिवन दैट इट्स वॉल्यूम इज 1/27 ऑफ द टोटल. इट मीन्स इफ दिस इज वन, टोटल मस्ट बी थ्री. दिस इज वन, टोटल मस्ट बी थ्री. राइट, क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट हाइट अबव द बेस द सेक्शन हैज टू बी कट. नाउ फ्रॉम द बेस इट शुड बी कट एट ए हाइट ऑफ 20 सेंटीमीटर. Because if total is 3, this must be 10 and this must be 20. Here I can say 4th becomes my answer. Length of each side of a regular tetrahedron is 12. We have to find the volume, right? We know that volume is a cube by, I have learned a cube by 6 root 2, right? So just take it as a cube by 6 root 2. So here I can say 12 cube, 12 into 12 into 12 upon 6 root 2. 6 will go on 2. Multiply by root 2 and divide by root 2. Right, this is 2, cancel out. The answer is said to be 144 root 2. First becomes my answer. The radius of a circular end of a truncated conical bucket which is 40 centimeter, 45 height, be 28 and 7. Capacity of the bucket, direct apply the formula. That is the formula for volume of a frustum. That is said to be 1 by 3 pi R1 square plus R2 square plus R1 into R2 into H. That's the standard formula for finding the volume of the bucket. Just solve it and answer your question. I hope you enjoyed the session. Now, after watching the 10 sessions, you will be comfortable with the basic concepts of geometry and mensuration. Most of the things, most of the questions we have taken. We have some more sessions on that geometry and mensuration. You may watch, enjoying the sessions. And all the best for your SSC mains examination, so that after watching this session, you get some confidence in order to crack it. Thank you very much.